Hello, I'm Dr. Aizaz from medicovisual.com, and in today's visual lecture, we will talk about the concept of positive sense and negative sense strands. Now, these terms, they are widely used in microbiology when we talk about the viruses, specific viruses. You might have read somewhere that it is written that one specific virus is, let's say, positive sense RNA stranded virus, and then another virus, it is, let's say, negative sense RNA virus. So these terms that are widely used in microbiology, what they actually mean. So we will understand it, this very basic concept that we will try to grasp today in this visual lecture. So let's suppose that here we have an RNA strand, for example. So here is an RNA strand. Now, if this RNA strand, it can be directly coded, it can be directly translated into, this is RNA, it can be directly translated into a protein, for example, a surface protein may be formed out of it. Okay, so let's suppose this surface protein may be formed out of it. So if it can be directly converted, directly translated into protein, simple as that, then it is called positive sense. So here is the translation process. So simple as that, that if an RNA strand, it can be directly translated into protein, then this is the positive sense. It makes a perfect sense. And it can be easily translated into the protein. Now, sometimes what happens that if there is an RNA strand, for example, which is complementary to it, it might be confusing for you. So let me explain these things to you first. So for example, there is, let me write the sequence for these. For example, this is AA, this is U, the nucleotide sequence, for example, G, then for example, C here, then A here. I'm just arbitrarily writing a few codons, not codons, few nucleotide sequences here. Now, what happens that if there is another strand, let me draw another strand. Here we have another strand of RNA again. Now this strand is complementary to it. You know, in it's a basic rule in the cell biology that in A, there in front of A there should be T, or if there is RNA then there should be U, and in front of G there must be C. So for example, instead of A here we have U, because it's RNA, it's not DNA. Then we have in front, rather than the second nucleotide sequence, rather than being U, we have A. Then rather than being G, we have C. Then rather than being C, we have G here. Then rather than being A, we have U here. Then again U here, this here. And then rather than G, we have C. Then rather than U, we have A. Complementary sequences there, then C, and finally we have, rather than C, we have G. Now if this is the strand here, now this strand, can it be directly translated? You tell me that, can it be directly translated into the protein? So it cannot be directly translated into protein. It makes no sense. It's a negative sense. It's complementary. Although it's complementary to RNA, what I mean by complementary is that if I take this, where is this, this one, if I take this, pick this up, and if I take it here, it will attach here easily here, because it's a complementary sequence. U will attach here, A will attach here, and so on. It's perfectly complementary to it. I hope you got the point. But it cannot be directly translated. It cannot be directly translated into protein. It makes no sense. It's a negative sense strand. It must be converted to this type. It must be converted into positive sense RNA. So another definition of positive sense RNA strand is simple as that RNA strand which can directly act as messenger RNA. You know, in humans and other eukaryotes, the messenger RNA, is directly translated. It's a transcript which is directly translated into the protein. So RNA strand, which can directly act as mRNA molecule, and hence it can be directly translated, such type of RNA strand is called positive RNA strand. But negative RNA strand is the strand which is, even though it is complementary to positive sense RNA strand, but it cannot be directly translated into protein. It must be converted into the positive sense. And how it can be converted? It's very simple. A complementary strand must be formed in front of it. For example, a copy of it will be formed, and then that copy will be obviously complementary to it. For example, here there will be A, here there will be U, in front of C there will be G. So in front of G there will be C, in front of U there will be A, then in front of U again A, G, and so on. I hope you got the concept. And now you see the sequence is exactly the same as this one. So now it has become positive sense. So if we make a complementary copy in front of it, we make a complementary copy in front of negative sense RNA strand, this negative sense will become positive sense. And similarly, if we make a complementary copy of positive sense strand, it will become negative sense strand. For example, here there will be U and here will be A and so on. So this is the basic concept of positive sense and negative sense. And simple as that, that some viruses, some RNA viruses, they have positive sense strands inside them, that they directly act as mRNA and they can be directly translated into protein. For example, if I remember correctly, SARS-CoV-2, the COVID-19 virus, it is also positive sense. It also contains positive sense RNA strand. But some viruses, they have negative sense strand, that strand must be first converted into positive sense strand by making complementary copy, and then that can be translated into protein. It cannot be directly translated into the protein. Now, this concept of positive sense and negative sense strand, as I have told you, it is actually related with RNA, but some people, some authors, they also extrapolate this concept related to the DNA. For example, let's talk about human DNA. That human DNA consists of two strands. It is a double-stranded DNA. So let's make a DNA molecule here. Not complete DNA, just a part of DNA molecule, and so here it consists of two strands, and one of these two strands is negative sense and the other one is positive sense. Now let me explain this thing to you and then you will understand what I mean by this. Now let's suppose it is containing a gene. Any gene could be there. So if we want to translate, we want to make protein out of it, we want to make the protein from this gene, then what will happen? That it will unwrap. So this gene, this DNA, the part of DNA where the gene is present, it will slightly unwrap, and then the RNA polymerase will come and make RNA from it. So let me explain this to you. For example, here there will be like this. So slightly there will be unwrapping will be there here, and here is the other strand. So here is the other strand. Now what will happen, that this is a negative sense, the red one strand is the negative sense strand, and it is the template strand. Now in front of the template strand, the RNA polymerase will come and it will make a complementary copy of RNA in front of it. So complementary copy will be formed in front of it. I am not gonna explain the process that how transcription occur, but the point that I want to mention here is that it will be complementary to it. Again, if I write the sequence here, now in front of U, A, C, G, in front of U there will be A, then in front of A there will be U, in front of C there will be G, in front of G there will be C, and here will be C, here will be G, here will be G. It's a complementary to it, I hope you can understand. A, and in front of A there will be what? U. And here, if we make the same complementary, of course these two DNA strands, they are also complementary to themselves, to each other I mean. So there will be again A, but instead of U there will be T, then there will be G, there will be C, there will be C, then there will be G, guanine, guanine, and not uracil, there will be T here, right? So now you can see that this mRNA, here is this mRNA, and this is positive sense mRNA, positive sense mRNA strand, because it can be directly translated into protein. So this positive sense mRNA strand, it must be coded from the template strand. This is the template strand, and this template strand must be negative strand. So it must be negative strand. So from the DNA from which this mRNA is copied, because this mRNA will be formed complementary to that strand, because it should be a positive sense RNA. So the strand from which it must be copied, that strand must be not positive sense, it must be negative sense. So it can, we cannot make an mRNA in front of it, in front of this green strand, this positive sense DNA strand, we cannot form in front of it, because the sequence will be exactly opposite, then it will become negative sense mRNA, which we do not want. We want positive sense mRNA so that it could be directly transcribed, not transcribed, so that it can be directly translated into protein. So if we extrapolate the concept of negative sense and positive sense strands to DNA, then naturally the template strand the complementary copy of which should be formed, that template strand of the DNA is negative sense strand, and the other strand which is not in front of which there is no complementary mRNA is formed, that type of DNA strand is negative sense strand. And we can also look it in another way, that if a strand of DNA is, if, now listen to this carefully, if the strand of DNA is very similar, it is exactly like, just there is the difference of U and T, if the strand of DNA is exactly alike, exactly similar to mRNA, then this DNA strand is positive sense. But if a DNA strand is not exactly alike, if the DNA strand is not exactly alike, but it is complementary to mRNA, then that complementary DNA strand is the negative sense strand. Because in front of negative, the complementary copy, when the complementary copy will be made, that complementary copy will naturally become positive sense strand. I know it's a bit complicated topic, it's difficult to explain, but I have tried my best to explain this concept. Now in this video, I will not go into cramming stuff, that I won't make you cram that XYZ viruses are positive sense and ABC viruses are negative sense. You can read that in your textbooks, there are lots of reference material available, you can follow that, but basic concept that is often overlooked and that is not often mentioned clearly in the textbooks, that is the concept of negative sense and positive sense strand that I tried to explain in this video. I hope you learned something from this video. Thank you so much for watching this video. Have a great day. Goodbye.